Itching to play more Theros Limited after the PTQ season ends? Come to GP Sacramento on January 17th to 19th, hosted by Channel Fireball and Cascade Games. If the newly increased GP prize structure doesn't convince you, maybe our featured artists will. Mark Teeden, Steve Argyle, Chuck Lukacs, RK Post, and Wesley Burt will all be making appearances. Come to GP Sacramento and give the year 2014 a monstrous start.
Hey everyone, welcome to another Cube Draft here. Cube's on for just a little while, and you can use qualifier points from the Magic Online Championship Series to enter, which I've got a couple of, so here I am. Actually in the same queue as Cedric, since I was watching his stream, and he was going to hop in a Cube Draft, so I decided to close his stream and then hop in the same draft. So this pack's got a lot of good options. Sword of War and Peace is pretty insane. Vendilion Click is very good. I don't actually like Vampiric Tutor in not unpowered cubes, which this is at the moment. Tundra is a decent first pick. Oblivion Ring's fairly safe, but kind of unexcited. Gaia's Cradle is a really insane card if you get the right deck. And I do like that green ramp deck. It's also Ash Zealot and Grim Lavamancer. I would take the Grim if I wanted to be mono red, but I feel like I've done that a lot recently. I don't like Spear of Heliod or Fleecemane Lion, so much like most Cube Pick 1, Pack 1s, it's really what you want to draft. And, I kind of just want to take this guy's Cradle. I'm just going to take the Cradle to start with, since I really like drafting those decks. Of course, I instantly regret it, since this pack's actually much worse than the last one, since last one had a bunch of viable first picks. I actually don't see any cards here that I would really be happy first picking. I mean, there's Molten Rain, I guess, but again, not trying to slam Monored again. There's Bloodstained Mire's Treetop Village, which isn't horrendous for the green deck. I really don't want a second pick of Treetop Village. I might just take Dismember. Oh, okay, I got some Phantom Points from a seal I did earlier. I think I might just take a Dismember here, just because it's colorless, it goes in any deck, and it's pretty decent. Because Bloodstained Mire is not the right color. Fetchland, I don't really want to take Weathered Wayfarer, Steplinks, any of those things. Alright, let's just take Dismember, see where we go. Alright, kind of doing it. Oracle Moldiah is really awesome too. I really like it in this deck, so let's take Oracle Moldiah. Not really worry about the Chain Lightning and Ball Lightning that are getting passed. The rest of the cards aren't super spectacular though. Gideon's fine, Necrotal's fine. Mindstone's pretty good, but nothing super exciting. And Raffaello's fourth pick. Alright, well, we are in the right archetype then. Easy Slam of Raffaello's. Like Cradle, it's one of the best cards for this archetype. And passing on a Sylvan Carrier. There's also Goblin Guide, so Mono Red is open. Imagine a lot of people are just taking blue cards or something? I'm not sure exactly. Alright, couple good options here. There's the Slagstorm that we're going to lose to, and then there's Stunted Growth and Court of Calling. I like them both, but I kind of want to just take Stunted Growth. That card is such a beating. If you resolve that card, I don't see how your opponent ever wins. Court is nice too, but Stunted Growth seems like it's a little safer too, because there are kind of two types of green decks here. There's the Cradle one that uses all the like one-drop elves. Then there's sometimes the green big green ramp decks that have less elves, more rampant growths, and Raffaello's type cards. Even though I'd rather have all the elves, sometimes you don't get that option. All right, now I can take a Restock, a Maze of Ith, or a non-green card. I'm not in love with any of these non-green cards. I kind of just want to take Restock here and just continue hedging. Like, Mother of Runes is a very powerful card, so Magma Jet's decent, Bone Shatter's decent, but they are cards you want to play early, and I don't like playing a lot of non-force decks, or cards in my decks. Alright, well, Death Cloud actually is an exception. Of course, I go from not wanting to play another colored card to a triple color card, but Death Cloud's just like a giant beating. It's, I guess, not really a combo with Gaia's Cradle. It's kind of sweet with Raffaello's. Of course, I could also take Remand, since this deck does end up blue-green a lot, and Remand is kind of perfect for the deck. Yeah, I kind of talked myself into Remand. There's a Trigon Predator too, but I like Remanding spells. And Flooded Grove. One of the ways that you know whether your deck's going to work or not is whether you have dual lands. So Flooded Grove is better than Spell Pierce or Force Spike, since without Flooded Grove, I'm not playing blue cards anyway. And Dissipate Wield, so did Tundra, and Oblivion Ring, and the Tracker, also Fleece Mainline, Spear. I'm a little more surprised about the Tundra, or the most surprised about Tundra, followed by Oblivion Ring, and then the rest of the cards, not hugely surprising. I don't really love Tundra here. Tracker is not great in this sort of deck. I could just take Dissipate. It's good in the blue-green deck. Yeah, seems decent. Alright, now I guess I'll just take the Wooded Bastion. Just in case I do want to play white, I'm not going to play any of these early cards. Gideon or Serum Visions? I actually kind of want to go Serum Visions. I don't think I love Gideon and Cube, so let's just take that, and then black, white, and blue, red are not really the kind of duels that I'm looking for here. I don't think Skorak really does much. I guess Celestial Purge is a decent sideboard card. Braids is sweet. If I can cast a turn three Braids. Alright, I can also just take Cascade Bluffs. I like just taking lands just in case. And then some kind of chaff picks. Alright, so did get Raphelos like fourth, so that's pretty strong. Don't have a huge incentive. Ooh, Deathcloud Last. Alright, that's a thing. Passed on some black cards, but I mean, I could end up Deathclouding here. Have an Oracle as well for mana, so Raphelos and Oracle for mana, and then Remand is one of my better tempo cards, but Seer Vision's Dissipate don't pull me very strongly. Dismember, obviously, it doesn't really matter too much. They'd rather play in green-black, but it's not a huge deal. And then Stone of Growth and Restock is kind of my finishers. Restock gets a lot better, by the way, if you have blue cards. Restocking green cards is not as exciting as restocking blue cards. All right, well, this pack's not fantastic. Certainly not. There's Mana Leak. There's Obstinate Bailoff, Histrionon, and Kozilek. Don't really like Painted Prism much, and I like Zealous Conscript, so I don't really need another color here. Might actually just take the Kozilek. Kozilek is a pretty strong card to ramp out, so I think I'll take an Eldrazi here. The Eldrazi also don't never go late, whereas if Dissipate Wield, Mana Leak might, you know, that sort of thing. So I'll just take my 10-drop and be happy. Ooh, Lotus Cobra. Yeah, Sulfuric Vortex. Message sent, but not received. Alright, well, Lotus Cobra is a pretty clear pick. It's a nice card. It works well with Oracle and Guy's Cradle, actually. And there's not much else that actually would really even interest me, so seems like an easy one. Alright, what do we got now? Not a lot of green cards. There's a Wicker Bow Elder, which I could take. I mean, this card's not the worst. There's also Snapcaster Mage to go with my, Snapcaster Mage Stun Growth. Actually, have Dismember, Serum Visions, Remand, Dissipate. Snapcaster Mage actually doesn't look terrible here. And if I can't wheel a Wicker Boulder, I'm not going to be too sad about it. Also, it will likely wheel. And the rest of these cards, I mean, I don't really like the Master Core. None of these duels interest me. Not even the Volcanic. And Blue Blast is a good sideboard card, but there's good red cards going in both directions, so I will pass on that. Alright, probably have to take the Boreal Druid here. If I want Cradle to work, I need one drops, and even though it's pretty much the worst of the one drops, it is decent. I don't love Show and Tell, since a lot of things can beat even like a Kozilek. And I don't love gifts. I mean, I like the card gifts, but and I do have Snapcaster Mage and Restock, which is nice, but I think Boreal Druid is actually just way more important. I've got a lot of the late game Dirtily cards already. I like Yavimaya Elder as well, but I think you need actual accelerants here. Thassa, God of the Sea. Alright, Breeding Pool. Well, that's easy pick. With Raphelos in your deck, then you're going to want all the blue-green duels you can get. I like Tauren too, but nothing can hold a candle to Breeding Pool. Ooh, and Primal Command. I mean, not much else I really want. I don't really love Spreading Seas. Flame Tongue's decent, but don't really want to splash another color, and Primal Command is not bad. Can go off for Primal Command Snapcaster Mage. Jeez, I just get to do all sorts of things. Alright, there's some cards here. Deadridge Chant and Deed are both kind of interesting, though Deed actually seems pretty bad here. And Deadridge Chant seems a little slow and a little the wrong color. Same with Shriek Maw. Because I don't think I'm Death Clouding at this point. There's also Thieving Magpie, which is decent. Palancron, which can be pretty nice. And Exploration. Exploration's sweet, but I think I've got Oracle's got that covered, and it is, you know, net minus one card here. So I'm leaning towards Palancron over Magpie. I think this deck is not looking to Magpie, though I guess a turn 3 Magpie is pretty nice. And am I going to go infinite here? Probably not. Alright, I'll just take the Magpie. I'll try that. Ooh, Simic Skyswaller, that's what I'm talking about. I mean, I like Fathom Seer and Misdirection well enough, but Simic Skyswaller is kind of the endgame this deck wants and deserves. Time to take the Pentide Prism, I suppose. I mean, I'm not playing Bloodbraid Elf. It's got some kind of random cards in the deck for Bloodbraid, and I guess I actually could take Flash Freeze as a sideboard card. Because I don't really like Pendant Prism in decks like this. Alright, no, I'll take the Flash Freeze. The problem is, this deck's not really about turboing out one thing. It's about consistently playing expensive spells, and Pendant Prism does not help with that. Halimar Depths is pretty nice with Oracle, so it's a nice little pickup. And the Blue Blast Wield, though the Wicker Builder did not. Alright, I'm not getting a ton of green here, but I mean, I picked up a Lotus Cobra, picked up Boreal Druid. If I can just get another couple of green accelerants, I actually think I'll be in pretty good shape here. And I'll have good sideboard against red. What do these cards do? Revelark seems like the most likely to get played. I don't think I need to play a Murmuring Bosk or a Brushland. I'll just take the Lark and then probably not play it. Good. Take it on a Lark there, as it were. I'm also pretty well set for expensive cards. I've got Kozilek, Simic Skyswaller, Primal Command, Restock, and Stunning Growth. So Yeah, definitely looking for more of the accelerant type stuff. Alright, take the Shadow Mage and pass Necro and Sign of Blood. Kami seems like a card I could potentially sideboard. And this card's pretty grotesque. Alright, what's the best card to open here? I don't know. I mean, I already have Lotus Cobra, Rephelos, and Cradle, which are fairly strong in this archetype, though Cradle's not actually looking insane here. Basically, I just need to pick up like two or three 1-2 cost mana acceleration creatures, so elves of all various flavors.